We've always been involved in conservation. We love being out in the outdoors. We all spend a lot of time tramping, and we'd often come across predator traps that had gone off with a dead animal or had no food for the animal to get it enticed. So Kevin, our inventor, he went away and just said, oh, how hard is this to make it automatic? So the thinking started basically with us being out in the bush and enjoying what we have here and recognising that the birds and the forests are under pressure. So, you know, what sort of solution can we come up with? So I'm Hayden Steel, the operations manager at NZ AutoTraps. We make an automatic resetting, rebaiting multi-species pest trap, which you can leave out in the environment for up to 6 months. It automatically resets and rebates each time it kills. Our factory is based in Whakatāne. So back in 2019, we received funding from Predator Free 2050 Limited through their products to projects funding. Part of that funding is we had to move to a region, so we've set up in Whakatāne, home of the Kiwi. So we just thought that was a great place to locate to. We've had a number of challenges along the way. When we received our funding, we had a working prototype. Once this had been in the environment in the bush for 6 to 2 years, we found out we had design issues. So we've worked a lot with our customers to fix those issues. We've listened to feedback. Products currently on the market are our AT220, which is our standard model. So available on our website or through bulk purchases. And we also have our species-specific AI trap on the market now. So that is species-specific, has an onboard processor and camera. So we can identify which species we want to kill and just activate the trap when something enters that we want to go. That also sends information via a yarn mesh network back to the operator's office or laptop, and it all comes with an information management system which collates all the kills and all the data and also works as a monitoring tool. The trap also works off a solar battery, so the only servicing we need to do is the lure, and at the moment we're working on a solution to get that out to 12 to 18 months between servicing, so that will totally drop the cost of labour down. NZ AutoTraps currently export to a number of countries. We're targeting mongoose in the Pacific and also in the Caribbean. We're getting really good results with that, catching multi-species. We're also catching tree snakes in Guam. We're getting a really good success rate there. We've worked really hard with their R&D teams over there to modify our trap for that. And we're also working on grey squirrels up in the UK and around the place. So yeah, we're getting a lot of international interest.